Hi, it's Kevin May, the Editor-in-Chief of PhocusWire, here in the PhocusWire studio at the PhocusWire Conference. Raphael Zier, you're the co-founder and president of PerfectStay. Welcome. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
It's an interesting model, isn't it? What
it
you've
is.
Got there.
Yeah.
Who would you say who do you compete against? Who do you watch to kind of benchmark yourself against?
You know, the thing is that we are a special beast, if I can say, because we can't find someone that really look like what we are. We are only B2B2C, and most of the players around are B2C and sometimes doing some B2B, which changed the focus. We only focus on B2B2C, so meaning we are working for big brands and focus on that. So it makes huge difference. And the thing is, most of the people providing vacation package to others are within white label model.
Yeah.
So if you think about it, it's a copy of what already exists somewhere behind a brown a logo. We don't believe that clients, which are now aware, look around, will be satisfied by having something that you can find somewhere else. We bring custom store. That means that when we work with Air France or Emirates, what you find in the store is unique.
Yep.
You won't be able to find this offer anywhere else, and you won't be able to find this price anywhere else.
How do you ensure that it is unique? I mean, is it part of the relationship that you then have with the customer that you allows you to get that kind of unique rate?
I think we absolutely know it's unique because we build offers based on an hotel deal plus flight. And the hotel deals, we sign an exclusivity while we are selling this product. So it's very short time selling window. So we sell for 7 days or 14 days a product, and we have lots of them turning. Mm-hmm. You can, of course, within the 7 day book for the next summer, but this offer is live only for a few days. And we have the exclusivity on that. So you won't be able to find this offer anywhere else. So then when you think about this offer, you had lots of them on top, and then you have a unique store, which is changing on a daily basis. You know, we don't have a fixed inventory.
Mm-hmm.
This is something that is changing all the time.
So on the one hand, then it's probably quite compelling for people like Air France then?
It is. It is absolutely attractive for...
Which I get. So, yeah. But when you first went to them with the idea, was there some kind of pushback? Maybe not necessarily Air France, but some of the other brands that you work with, because they didn't understand it, or they didn't see the potential of it, or what?
I think it's the opposite.
Yeah.
They thought it was a great idea, and that's why we came up very quickly with the product live. Because when we met Air France the first time, we only had a PowerPoint. And we also, of course, have a great experience in the industry, which helps them to trust us. But, you know, at the first place, they realized that, wow, if we can put amazing deal on hotel with our flight, then it will create some incremental business. And that's exactly what happened. If you have an amazing price, I don't know if you live in Paris or London and you want to go to Prague, for 150 euro or pound, you go to Prague, five-star hotel, mm-hmm. the flight, you go. And that's what happened. And then you fly on Air France or Emirates or the partners we are working with.
Do you have any challenges around the packaging aspect of it? I mean, in Europe, where you and I are from, package travel regulations and all those kind of things, does that have an impact on what you're able to do and the way you bring things together?
In fact, it has a positive impact on our business because we are, from the beginning, designed under these regulations.
Yeah.
We are a baby company, so we already knew that we had to be set up for that. So when we come to an airlines or when we come to an e-commerce website or media who wants to provide our clients with amazing package deal, they don't want to be in charge, you see what I mean?
Yeah.
So we are fully in charge. And I think a strength of our model is that when we go to a partner, we we ask him just to do one thing, promote the service. Then we do everything from the sourcing, the technology, the client services, and the legal and financial responsibility as a tour operator would do.
Okay. And finally, Raphael, I mean, you raised 17 million in May this year. That's a fairly modest amount of money. I mean, what do you spend $17 million on?
It's quite a nice fundraising for our first one. The objective for that is to roll out internationally our offer. You know, we started in France,
So
we had quite a success in France. Now we want to be in the other countries. So we already started because we raised the money 6 months ago. Okay. So we've launched two new markets. UK.
And what do you have? Sorry, just on that.
Yeah.
What do you have to do to launch into a new market that is kind of, you know, cost heavy? Then is it staffing up, offices, or is it?
It's not so heavy. In fact, you need to have the team with the native language. So for the content, because we produce our own content, and for the client services. And then you need to make sure you are compliant with the country regulation. I mean, for instance, UK has ATOL. You need to have ATOL to do business in the UK. After that, we operate the same type of deal, worldwide. You know, everybody goes to, I don't know, New York, Paris, Maldives, Bali. If you're French, British, German, you go there.
Yeah. Okay. So, Raphael, thank you very much for talking to us.
Thank you.